heart goes out to essentially a big, powerful beast that, because of so many different circumstances, has been left very vulnerable.
Yeah.
How did you come across his plight?
A friend of mine, Shirley, who runs the White Lion Foundation, was telling me about him. And, of course, we were chatting and I said, oh, can I do anything?
And there you are, here you are.
Here I am, and thank you for
everything.
Of this particular rhino, this subspecies of black rhino, there's about 250...
Wow.
I think it's 254, actually, left, but only about 100 of those black rhino are black male breeding rhinos.
Right.
So there's not a lot, and so we need to help them out a bit.
Yeah, absolutely, because it is species like this that we can see and identify that really capture our imaginations about the state of a lot of species that are under threat.
Yes, it's happening to a lot, but this is really, I mean, 254, there's not
terrifying.
A lot left, are there?
No.
So the hope is that he'll help that species continue.
Over the years, Helen, we've spoken to you on so many occasions, back on the previous incarnation of The Breakfast Show on GMTV and here on Good Morning Britain. Your passion for these extraordinary creatures sort of seems to never to abate, really. Do you get frustrated that we're still in this situation? Do you feel like you're getting somewhere?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I think the poaching of ivory is one thing that has gone on for such a long time. And, you know, will it ever stop? I don't know. But that doesn't mean you don't stop trying.
No.
Does it?
No.
Do you think more people are listening now?
More people?
Do you think more people are listening,
I think possibly. Yes, I think they are. That's, indeed. And hopefully people will listen this morning.
Yeah, about, and get involved and do more for it. Yeah. Because it is, I think we've, what man is doing to our world is certainly something that occupies the headlines, never mind our conversations, extinction, rebellion, capturing people's attention in various cities. Does that help you in a way to feel like we're going forward?
I hope we're going forward. I just, every time I hear a new story, just it fires me up again, really. Because these creatures have been around for so long. I don't actually know how long. I must find out. But
I'll tell you how long you've been on Coronation Street, though. Not that you're
not
facing
fair.
Extinction, can I just point out very, very quickly.
Oh, thank you very much.
No, we don't want that. 40 years, isn't it?
45.
45?
45 years.
You see, I was trying to be nice. You can't say that. You can't really say that. 45 years. I mean,
it's
how
ridiculous.
Fantastic.
It is. It's ridiculous.
So you've seen every possible, come and go, the roller coaster of working on a set like that.
And I'm still there.
And you're still there and still thriving.
Yes,
and we love you on the show as well.
Thank you.
But there have been a lot of stuff in the press recently, a lot of speculation about morale on Coronation Street, about the pressures of the schedules. I mean, you knew it before you knew it. Now, what is it really like there at the moment?
It's fantastic. Mm. It's a fabulous place to work. And, I work with an amazing family anyway and have been working with them for a long time. And everyone who joins us seems to join in with us. I mean, yes, it's hard work. There are 6 episodes a week, but the camaraderie is fantastic. And we're all in it together.
Yeah.
And, I wouldn't have changed any of it, really.
No, and we wouldn't change being there either, Helen. Thank you so much for coming in and bringing Munu to our attention as well.
Thank you. If you can go to the White Lion Foundation to have a look at
the website.
The website, that would be fantastic.
Lovely to see you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Helen.